Hi everyone, I am Jamie Palmer, business coach and simplifier for driven entrepreneurs, course creators, and service providers who want to build an online business. I am the creator of the group program Business Ecosystem Builders, where I help entrepreneurs like you focus on one signature program so that they can create more freedom in their lives. In today's video, I am going to help you become a Canva pro. I'm going to share a lot of different ninja tips today on how to remove backgrounds, create GIFs, organize, use templates, and some more of my favorite features in Canva. If you're enjoying this content, be sure to hit the subscribe button. Every single week, I share new videos about marketing and online business. Business in 2003, the only way to get beautiful graphics was to hire a high-end designer or learn Illustrator or Photoshop. Neither one of those things were a lot of fun to do. And so nowadays we have the option to be able to leverage Canva. Canva is an amazing tool that allows you to create beautiful graphics so you never have to worry about the way in which your business looks in the online space. So stay tuned, I'm gonna share with you all my favorite ninja tips on how to become a Canva pro. All right, let's dive into the 10 tips for becoming a Canva pro. So I'm in Canva here and I'm gonna go over to create a design and we're just gonna use an Instagram post for purposes of this training today. So one of the things that I just want to kind of accustom you to is this sidebar over here. And here you'll find templates, uploads, which uploads are your own things that you've uploaded. You'll find photos like through stock photos. You'll find different elements that you can use inside your design, some of which are animated. You can then add text. You can add different styles in terms of colors and as well as your own brand kit. You can add music and videos and backgrounds. And then these are the folders where all of your stuff is organized. And then if you go under this more tab, you can also find different apps and integrations here that you can use. So today, I am going to start with showing you how to remove a background from a photo. So let's find a photo over here of me. So I'm going to put this photo on here and I am, that's not my favorite photo of me. So I'm going to put this photo here and I am going to go over to effects. It's right here. And as you can see here, there are lots of different things that you can apply to make this photo look in a different way. But this first one that you see here is the background remover. So I'm going to hit the background remover and it will magically remove the background from this photo. So as you can see here, it does a really pretty good job. So one of the things that you can do here is you can restore parts of the picture by clicking on this button. And I'll show you an example of that. So it can bring back pieces of the picture here. And I don't want to do that, so I'm going to hit the cancel. As you can see here, it's removed the background of the photo. And you might want to do a little cleanup here and there, but for the most part, you can see you can now use this photo with stuff in the background and put this on top of other different things. So it becomes really easy to then, you know, change, add colors and stuff behind it. So as you can see, you'll have this whole, this photo will pop up and I can then use this with copy and whatever else that I want to do here. So the other thing that I really love about Canva is the brand kit. So if you click on this home button, and you definitely have to have the pro version to do this, but it's worth the,
I think it's $100 a year now, or $119 a year, to come over to this thing and unlock the pro version to get this brand kit. So what the brand kit does is it actually allows you to upload your brand photos, your brand colors, your brand fonts. And if they don't have the font within here, you can upload it. So essentially what you do is you'd go in here and you'd hit add, and then you go through and you'd either add your custom colors, which you just hit add custom palette, and then you'd hit the button and you'd type in whatever the code is here for your brand. And you would go through and you would do that for all the different colors that you have here. So this will just create a palette, and then you can type right in here and you can say sample palette, sample brand colors. And then you can also upload fonts. So if you have the fonts, you'd upload those here. So that really helps in terms of making sure that what you're doing is in alignment with the look and the color and the feel of your brand. And they make it really, really easy to do that. So the next thing that I want to share with you guys is the Magic Resize. So the Magic Resize is this really awesome tool that they have here. So I'm going to choose an Instagram post here, and I'm just going to use this template, and I'm going to swap out the colors, this color, and we'll just swap these out real quick. And then what I'm going to do is I am going to say, I want to resize this. So this is currently sized for Instagram. What you can do is you can click this resize button. And as you can see here, it shows you all sorts of sizes that I've used recently. And then if you keep scrolling down, you'll see you can choose a Facebook cover, an Instagram story, an infographic, like all the options are here. Or if you can't find it, you can say Facebook post. So you can click as many of these as you want. I'm going to use this Facebook post to show you as an example. So you hit copy and resize, and you want to make sure that you have pop-ups enabled from Canva, because you won't be able to see that. And then this just magically resized that whole thing. So I can publish direct to Facebook from here, or I can simply download this and save it to whatever scheduling software that I use. So the thing that I really love about Canva and what they've been doing is they've also added this animate feature. So as you can see here, you can click on these different options here to animate this as well. So it makes what's called a GIF, if you're familiar with those, and they are really cool for just downloading and showing up on social media. It kind of gives a little extra pizzazz. So you would, once you're done with your design, you'd hit that animate button, and then you can choose the amount of time here, and then you would just hit the download button to download it. So you can download it as an MP4 video. You can download it as a short clip with no sound. And if you did want to do it as an MP4 video, you could add music. So you would just put whatever music that you want to have in there. As you can see, it'll start to play. And then you just hit the download button so that you can download. Or if you just wanted to publish direct to Facebook, you'd hit publish to Facebook and you'd be good to go. Now, the next thing I want to show you guys is how to save a file without a background. So this happens a lot when you are doing something on a website or something like that. You want to have a transparent background for whatever it is that you are using. So let's look up my logo here as an example. So let's use this, the foundation, as an example. So what you'd want to do is you want to come in here and you want to say, okay, I want to do this, but I don't want it to have that big, clunky white background. So you're going to come over to this download button and you are going to select the transparent button tab. So hit that transparent button tab and then hit download, and that will download with a transparent background so that you'll get that really clean, nice look that you are going for. Now, one of the things that I think is really important with Canva is all the keyboard shortcuts. And they have a whole blog where you can do that. But one of the things that I like is you can do command. Oh, that didn't work. If you hit the T button, the command T button adds the text. The other thing that you can do here is you can upload your own photos, which I highly recommend just going through. And if you have a bunch of photos, just upload them all at once so they're in there, and it makes it a lot easier. And then of course, as I shared in my lead magnet video, Canva has tons of templates. So you can come in here and pretty much search for anything that you are looking for. So we'll just put social media in there as an example. And as you can see here, there are literally hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of options for creating really amazing social media posts. So just pick stuff that's in alignment with the look and feel of your brand and then go ahead and use those.
Be sure to comment below and let me know which ninja tip you are going to try first. If you want more content like this and truly want to build and scale your online business, be sure to get on the waitlist for my new program, The Foundation. We will help you plan, package, profit, prioritize, and promote your online business. This 90-day intensive program is for you if you are looking to grow and scale your business online. Be sure to head over to thefoundation.systems and get on the waitlist. One of the best ways to tell me that you are enjoying this content is to like and comment below. And of course, share with a business bestie. Thank you so much for tuning in and have a great day.